practitioners of Nollywood. We have lost five of our colleagues, two sound engineers, a makeup artist, an actor, and a production assistant. We have lost them to an avoidable death. Avoidable because all they needed to do to have given them fighting rights would have been to give them a life jacket. When you get in your car, it is a requirement by law that you wear your seatbelt. When you board an aircraft, by law and by practice, you wear your seatbelt. When you get on the boat, you wear your life jacket. Now you get to a jetty and the boat driver says there are no life jackets. You tell him, thank you very much. As a producer who is expected to be prepared, you should have made arrangements for life jackets. Just in case the boat driver didn't have them, you will dress your own people up because by law and by practice, you wear your life jackets. For those of us who are from the riverine, some of us can swim, some of us understand the tide, and so we may be able to speculate. But for a group of people who are not good swimmers, don't understand the tide, you put them in the boat without a life jacket, and you have the man ferrying them as an excited young man who has his ears blocked with earpod, probably listening to some music, and then he's the one ferrying people. No preparedness for anything. No guard, nothing. The artist is nothing to an inept producer. You put them. And even the people themselves, you have your rights as an actor. You need to know that you have rights. You should be able to say, I don't have a life jacket. I'm not going anywhere. I don't swim. Because you have right to a body double. If they don't like it, they can get someone else. You will not die. There's several other roles that you can play. Yes, money is hard, the economy is hard, but you see, life is priceless. Today we have a young girl who is her family's sole breadwinner gone. What will that family say or do? As a producer, it is a requirement that you do your job in a safe, secure, and free of intimidation environment. That's where you are expected to do your work. You need to be prepared or you don't start. You don't go to location without being prepared. You waste the time of people. And that's why we have all these kinds of unnecessary deaths. When people are not sick of high blood pressure, they're sick of diabetes and kidney, all lifestyle based. Question is, what is the lifestyle of the average Nigerian actor? And I'll tell you, work 18 hours, eat chaff instead of food. It's carbohydrate that comes too late sometimes. People work and then they eat at 12 midnight just before bed. And what do you think all that blood sugar will do? When that yam or rice or garri breaks down, it becomes sugar, Abby. And then people start when it starts most times before you know all the money that they have worked up that period and saved up, all of it goes back to doctors. And then when nobody can carry it anymore, we come to the public cap in hand. Emeka Rulas, where are you? This is the one time that we require you to put this up. The actors' welfare must be put on the table. We can't have everybody use us. Third largest producers of film, second highest employer of youth labor, blah, and all for what? Everything. We are the image makers. So we can't allow this happen. If we down tools, everybody will down tools. Let's put the actors' welfare on the table. We can't take one more unnecessary death. This death was avoidable. If the actors stood their ground and said, no, we're not boarding until we have life jackets, somebody will be alive today. If the producer made arrangements and ensured that there were life jackets, today the story will be different. So nobody should talk to me about faith. There is no faith. You people think all that God did was just so you can die untimely and in this manner. Look, actors' welfare on the table, please.